It was extremely scary. It's one of those things that you always prepare for, but you hope that you never actually have to use.
We faced the worst case scenario recently with Ajabu. To walk into that barn as we tried to just work through treatment plans was painful, but so important. I'm Harrison Adell. I'm the zoo's Executive Vice President of Animal Care and Conservation.
My name is Amy Carver, and I am the Assistant Supervisor in the Large Mammal Department. Ajabu is your typical four, almost five-year-old boy. He's super playful, very social. His favorite activity is throwing logs off of cliffs, chasing guinea fowl, and all around just being silly.
EEHV is a leading killer of young elephants, and it occurs both in the wild and in elephants in human care.
EEHV is elephant endotheliotropic herpesvirus. My name is Dr. Ann Bergdorf, and I am one of the associate veterinarians at the Dallas Zoo. There's still a lot we don't know about how EEHV is spread, but we assume that all elephants have it. There are several different strains of the virus. It lays dormant, and some animals may never have an issue, and we're not really sure what causes that.
An adult elephant with a robust immune system might be exposed to EEHV, but the virus may not have the same effect on them that it does on a younger elephant with a less robust immune system.
Once an elephant becomes sick with a virus, very few of them recover, even with treatment.
Our animal care staff have incredible relationships with the animals, which allows us to collect blood samples voluntarily from our elephant herd. Those blood samples allow us to screen the blood and test them regularly.
When we were monitoring Ajabu's routine blood work, we saw what we thought was just a small flare-up. And that can be totally normal. A lot of zoos are seeing that when they're monitoring their elephants.
We were keeping a little bit closer of an eye on him, but behaviorally, he was acting pretty normal.
He wasn't showing any clinical signs. He was acting healthy. He was eating. He was active.
Because there isn't a vaccine, the goal is to catch this virus early enough that we can respond to it and stay ahead of it.
We decided to up our frequency of monitoring, and so we started to collect daily blood samples. We noticed that there was a significant change in his blood values from the day before.
He started to just kind of act a little bit slower. His mannerisms were just a little bit slow. He walked in just a little bit slower than normal. Since we do work with him so much, we were able to see that he just wasn't being his normal self.
We knew that that was the first sign that this virus was causing an active illness in him, and it wasn't just a small flare-up. As soon as we saw that, we jumped into our treatment plan. The whole staff knew how serious this was going to be for Ajabu.
We were doing 24-hour care. We started off extremely aggressive at first because we wanted to try to get that viral load down as quickly as possible. We were administering fluids around the clock. We were also administering his medicine about four times a day. And then he was also getting whole blood and plasma transfusions as well.
He stopped eating as much. He became quieter. And then the most concerning sign that he developed was edema in his legs and on his belly. So what that means is that his blood vessels in his body are starting to leak fluid out. Some of that can be because they don't have enough platelets to clot, but also because he's losing protein.
The moment that we saw red flags on those first couple of blood tests, we reached out to a network of other zoos and institutions and labs with a heads up that we had an elephant that was battling this virus.
I think one of the things we learned is how generous the AZA community was, helping us obtain more antiviral medication, providing blood supplies, providing their knowledge and experiences to give us an idea of what we would expect to see. One of the places that we called was the San Diego Zoo Wildlife Alliance. Dr. Lauren Howard, one of their veterinarians there, has a great deal of experience with EEHV.
I was contacted by the veterinarians at the Dallas Zoo shortly after they got the result. Whenever someone has a sick elephant, everyone pitches in right away. They just send what they can and work together to try to get that elephant through. This is a virus that, through our work, we've learned has evolved naturally with elephants for millions of years. It's a part of their natural biology and their natural history. At the same time, we have found that this virus can cause elephants, both in human care and in the wild, to become very sick and die very suddenly, sometimes within a day or two of diagnosis.
EEHV, when it was first discovered, was originally thought to be a problem specifically in Asian elephants, but we have recently discovered that it's also a problem in African elephants. Once we learned that information, the Dallas Zoo developed a game plan to monitor our herd after the birth of Ajabu. I think we were all really grateful that we had a solid plan in place before this even happened, so we knew what to do. We were prepared ahead of time.
The Dallas Zoo veterinary and elephant teams were very ready for this virus. They've been doing all the work, all the preparations, all the regular monitoring and testing, and they were utilizing resources that the EEHV community had created. Well, I've been working with an amazing group of EEHV collaborators for at least the last 15 years. When I was a high school student, I actually met Kumari, who was a young Asian elephant calf at the National Zoo. And then I found out later in college that she died from EEHV, and she was actually the first elephant in the US that was identified to have EEHV. And from her blossomed a lot of work and research to better understand what this virus is and how it was killing elephants.
We were sending samples and getting blood all sorts of different ways. Things were being overnighted by FedEx. People were driving halfway across the country to meet other zoos that were driving to meet us. We had zoologists getting on planes to fly samples to be at the lab first thing in the morning.
We were also able to get blood from our own herd as well, which was also very helpful.
When one of our babies here at the park was born a few years ago, we were able to establish an African elephant stem cell line from their placenta that we were very happy to share. Stem cells help reduce inflammation and they help the elephant's own immune system fight back. We were also able to collect plasma from our elephants that was fortified with antiviral medication and send that frozen to Dallas Zoo. It wasn't just us, however. There were multiple zoos throughout the entire country with African elephants who were able to donate antiviral fortified plasma, as well as providing actual antivirals. And of course, moral support, which is a really important part of this as well.
We treated him for about 10 days, pretty aggressively. And about day 6 or 7, we started to see positive signs.
We were so happy once his viral load started to improve. It was just a huge sigh of relief.
That edema started to resolve, his appetite started to improve, and he was starting to get spunkier.
Everybody as a team was just working so hard. They were working 24 hours a day. We had help from all the other sections, and it was just such a relief to be able to see light at the end of the tunnel.
It was a lot of work, but it was worth all of it.
Because we know that EEHV is present in wild elephant populations, we're concerned about the impact of this virus on young elephants out in the wild. The opportunity to work closely with elephants in human care, it gives us the chance to understand this virus in new ways. If we are to create a vaccine, it's probably going to come about because we have the opportunity to work closely with elephants at places like Dallas Zoo and other accredited zoos.
There's still so much we don't know about this virus. We recently participated in a pharmacokinetic study, so looking at how a specific drug, one of the antivirals, famciclovir, works in African elephants. There is also another study that's going on looking at trunk washes, so we can see what their viral loads are.
Ajabu's doing really well now. It's night and day compared to how he looked. He's spending all of his time with mom again. He's spending time outdoors again.
He's doing great. He's right there. As you can see, he looks great. He's doing so much better. He's acting more like himself. He's being playful. He's out playing in the mud just like he normally does.
The dedication of the zoologists and the staff here is amazing. We were all in this together, and I'm so proud of this team and all the hard work that they do.
When an elephant lives or dies from an EEHV illness, it doesn't do it alone. It's not just one zoo. It's not just one elephant care team. It's the whole AZA community that pitches in to do everything they can to make sure that elephant has every opportunity to survive this terrible illness. It's that collaborative nature that really makes us do what we can to make sure the next elephant that gets impacted by EHV has every chance of survival.
That offering of support, it makes us feel like we're not alone out here when we're trying to deal with a really, really scary virus. But it also, in this case, very likely made the difference between life and death for an elephant that was battling this. We could not be more thankful to that network who all stepped up to the plate and offered support when we needed it.